They can stand alone as sentences. All right? I'm not going out, for I have been out every night this week. I am not going out is a sentence. Let's get rid of the coordinating conjunction there. I have been out every night this week. That is a sentence. Okay, we are joining them together there with for. So that's a compound sentence, all right? It's got two sentences joined together as one. So, let's make up little sentences for you here with the acronym, with these coordinating conjunctions, also known as independent conjunctions. Okay, let's start off with for. Now this is an interesting one here because for is a preposition. Well, of course it is. My family are coming for tea. I am going to the shop for a newspaper. Right? Yes. For is one of the most well-used words in the English language. That one there is the prepositional use of the word for. Right, as a conjunction, for really means it's similar to, it's like it's giving a reason. It's like, it's similar to because. It's similar to the word because, which is a subordinate conjunction, which we'll be coming on to in the next video. So how can you use for? How can you use for then? So it doesn't sound like a preposition. Well, it's all about a comma, isn't it? Be nice to John, for he's suffered enough. Be nice to John, comma, for he's suffered enough. You notice it's different. It's different to it's a different meaning of the word for to I'm going to the shop for a newspaper. For he's suffered enough. I've got to get out of this flat. For I am so bored. You see, a different meaning of the word for, and this meaning of the word for he's suffered enough there, is a conjunction. Okay, and as you see, both of these clauses are independent. Be nice to John. Let's take away the for, let's get rid of it. He's suffered enough. He's, that's a contraction of he has. It could also be he is, but in this case it would be he has. Be nice to John. So you could even put a full stop there. Full stop. Be nice to John. He has suffered enough. But be nice to John, for he suffered enough, sounds a little bit more interesting than, well, it's better English than saying be nice to John, he suffered enough. That's choppy, so that's the whole point about conjunctions, is to stop choppy talking, choppy English, which never sounds good. We don't speak like that, so why should we write like that? Here's some examples, by the way, of how things would look if we didn't have coordinating conjunctions at all. and. Okay. I am going to the beach in the morning and in the afternoon I am going home. I'm going to the beach in the morning and in the afternoon I am going home. Okay, your and there is acting as the coordinating conjunction. It's joining both these clauses together, and you can just verify that with me. You can check to see the bit before and, okay, the bit before and, does that have a subject and a verb? In the morning I'm going to the beach. In the morning I am is a verb. Going is a verb. Am going is a verbal phrase. To, of course, is a preposition. The adjective and beach is a noun. Okay? Putting your comma there. And in the afternoon, I am going home. Without and. In the afternoon, I am going home. In the afternoon, I am. You got your am over there. Am is a verb. So that is absolutely fine. So there's an example there with and. Notice there, both these clauses could stand alone as independent sentences. So let's move on to nor. Let's pretend I'm a doctor giving your son a sick note because he's hurt his leg, right? Steve shouldn't take part in physical education, nor should he participate in any sporting activity. Okay? You see there how they both join together with nor. Again, they would work as sentences, although one thing you try and avoid at all costs is starting a sentence with a coordinating conjunction. But I voted for the Conservatives, but Amy voted for Labour. I voted for the Conservatives, but Amy voted for Labour. That could be in the answer to a question. If somebody says, well, did you all vote for the Conservatives? I'd probably start off with an interjection, wouldn't I? I'd say, well, I voted for the Conservatives, but Amy voted for Labour. Okay, or I'll have to make a start in this work or I'll be here all night. I will have to make a start on this work or I will be here all night. I can see you today or I can see you tomorrow, to make it nice and simple. I can see you today or I can see you tomorrow. Okay, yet. John lives 5 minutes from school, yet he's late every day. So, you may remember that one there. And you think, ah, so I remember that. That's an adverb of manner. He is so good. Or, I am having so much fun making this video. As you see, indeed it is an adverb of manner, so it is modifying another adverb there. Much. So much. I am having so much fun making this video. That is also a simple sentence. I am having so much fun making this video. Simple sentence. There's no clauses, it rolls off the tongue, you see. That's totally different to the conjunction. So, totally different. I'm working late tonight, so I can't see you. He has not worked hard enough, so he can't get any pocket money.